Give or take another 100, 150 years, most of us are bound to be forgotten. And this is something that I've been thinking about for quite some time now. And I think that this is something every human ought to think about, because at the end of the day, we all are temporary, and there's honestly no better way to accept it than, I guess, talk about it. Human beings, out of all the other animals, are probably the worst when it comes to the fear of being forgotten. And that's probably why we erected tombs, statues, and busts of great people. At this point of time, it is pretty obvious to us that we all are pretty mortal beings. I believe that we have to look at the very root of what causes us to be fearful of being forgotten. So why do I fear being forgotten by people in the future? It's pretty simple when I put it this way. Is that all I am? All the emotions I feel, all the struggles that I've been through, and every kind of battle that most of us face, is that all it is? Is all of that bound to be forgotten? Because everything that I'm going through and everything that I'm fighting against and conquering, with all my heart and emotions, are eventually going to be forgotten, then why even bother putting up a fight? Is this just how temporary all of us are? Now, step two to answering this question: accepting the fact that we are all bound to be forgotten. The very act of accepting the fact that no matter how big a contribution you make, unless it's in the Einstein's level of contribution, we are all bound to be left behind, because that's just the way the world works. Because the world that we live in is hinged on the very word progress. The world will never know what can be unless it forgets what was. The third and final act of answering this question is there any way we can immortalize ourselves and do something that will make people remember us for a very, very long time? The answer is no. Yes. Now, there are going to be a handful of people that probably will be remembered by the rest of the human generation to come, because things have just worked that way for them. But for the other 99% out there, there is one thing we can do to immortalize ourselves. Work, work, and work your fucking ass off. This is something that I've been told time and time again, that if you have the fear of being forgotten, then why don't you do something that will make people remember you every single time they look at it? If it were that simple, everyone would have done it by now. Let's just face the fact that most of us want to appeal to the mass. Most of us want fame and fortune and all of that. There are going to be us that will be held back by the life circumstances, health problems, physical problems, name them. So for the good majority, I truly believe that the true way to immortalize ourselves is by understanding the fact that it is okay to take a step back from the rat race. And it is completely okay to turn the other fucking way around, because not everyone wants to go the same way. There are people who think differently. Not everyone wants fame and fortune. The ones that are the closest to us observe us the closest. This is pretty obvious, isn't it? But it's something that most of us tend to forget. Going behind the big picture dreams can often lead to us neglecting people who actually matter to us in our lives. There is absolutely nothing wrong with the fact that you can take the time to turn around and check if the rat race that you are in is the actual race you want to participate in. Because at the end of the day, all the cliche stuff that we, most of us hate to talk about, be it being nice to people or being a giving person, not someone who takes everything from someone else, or always being helpful to the elders, and all of that cliche and nice stuff, these truly build memories. Memories that will truly be lodged into people that are close to us, the ones who are truly observing us. So if the people closest to us know who we really are we ever forgotten?